Ladies and gentlemen, how are we doing? Cameron Stewart calling in here from the Southern Motorway here in Auckland. As you can see, we are in peak hour traffic here, and I don't know how many hours I spend on this motorway, but it's a lot. I hope you're all having an awesome day, and hey look, Joshy, how are you, mate? So what I wanted to talk about, just since I like to talk to myself on camera and just fill in time by putting live videos on Facebook, I thought I'd get on here and just talk about what value are we, or you, or we, or whatever, adding to others. You know, I think, especially in the business world, there's a lot of people that are only willing to help you if there's a transaction involved. And in a lot of ways, it really irritates me. I don't think it needs to be that way. It doesn't always have to be about a transaction. You know, for me, abundance or money or business and all the rest of that stuff happens when you do the right thing by people for a long period of time, and you build trust, and you build, you know, people know that you're of integrity and all the rest of it. Eventually the business comes to you. But what I'm seeing out there in the world is people don't give people the time of day unless there's a transaction involved. And I don't believe it has to be that way. It doesn't have to be that way. We need to be adding value to others. It might just mean saying hello to that person on the park bench, like, how's your day going? It might mean, you know, when you're at the gym, just taking time out of your day to say hello. So many people are walking around with their blinkers on and not taking time out of their day just to say hello to someone else. And I know I've covered this in a video previously, but it is so important to take time out of your day to say hello or introduce yourself to someone. We live in a world today where communication is gone. People are caught up in social media, people are caught up in on phones, or they're listening to music and they're just caught in this little zone, and they don't actually, you know, they don't even take notice of other people. You know, there might be someone who's an old lady's walked up, fallen over on the street or whatever the case may be, and people just walk straight past. People are so caught up in their own head and in their own life, they don't take time. So this is why I thought I'd do a video. What value are you adding to others? It doesn't have to mean you're helping, you know, thousands of people or anything crazy like that. It might just mean putting your hand out and shaking someone's hand. See, most people don't take the time out of their day anymore for others. We've created a society where we're very, very tunnel vision. We're very selfish in our actions. And I think we need to really think about what we're doing and taking time out to actually give a stuff about what other people are doing, like actually caring about other human beings. You know, so many people, you know, will just drive past someone that's standing in the rain or whatever the case may be because they're worried about what... Look, not everyone's bad. There's plenty of good people out there. And the same goes with business. Like, just... if you have a meeting with someone and they're not interested in your services or they're not interested in what you're doing, doesn't mean that we should cut those people. You should keep the relationship. And I speak this stuff from experience. Like, over the years, I have burnt so many people due to the fact that I was just very aggressive in what I was doing. I was trying to win, I was trying to succeed. And I sometimes it's important just to slow down and actually take time and think, well, what value am I actually going to add to this meeting? Whether or not that person gets involved in what I'm doing, or whether or not that person's interested in our services, or whatever the case may be, taking time out of your day and actually just enjoying that moment with someone else and learning something from someone. So many people, you know, unless they get a sale or whatever the case may be, they just cut those people. You don't know. If you leave a good taste in someone's mouth, that person could potentially lead you to a lot of businesses, or could lead you to someone that might be a really good member of your team, or whatever the case may be. So don't let it always be about a transaction, people. What value are you actually adding to other people? You know, obviously in the real estate game, I'm not a real estate agent, but I deal with a lot of real estate agents. And the biggest problem with a lot of the real estate agents today is they don't actually take the time out to actually build the relationship when the market was going gung-ho and deals were getting done all over the show. They forget about the people that were there when the market was crap. They forget to build the relationships. They're so focused on what it is that they're doing. So it's so important to take the time out, like answering a phone call. is common courtesy. Not only in business, but in life. If someone texts you, always text them back. If you're not interested in getting involved in something, let the person know. Don't just hide behind social, digital media like telephones or whatever the case may be. So many people hide behind, digital media today. Like David, who I see just got on here, has a very successful insurance business. And I know in his case, a lot of people would, he might try to follow someone up and those people won't answer or they won't return a call. Now, it's common courtesy in the world today to actually just, have the decency to call someone back. Where did it become normal just to not call someone back and let them know that you're not interested in that service or that product or whatever the case may be? Like, common courtesy is lost in today's society. And that's why I say it in the title of this video, what value are you actually adding to other people? You know, where you go, are you actually leaving an impact? Do people know who you are? Or do you just go through life hiding behind your sunglasses, hiding behind yourself? Are you so self-conscious that you can't even say hello to someone else because you're worried or whether or not that person's going to say hello back? Like, this is the world that we live in today. Why are we living like that? We're all human beings. We should all be adding value to other people in some way or form. If you've got children and you're going to taking the kids to kindy or whatever, like introducing yourself to all the different parents. Like, you don't know the friendships that you might be able to create out of that. We live in such a confined society today. People go to work, people come home, they sit there watching television, they watch Shortland Street and all this other crap. They filled their mind with rubbish. They're too busy watching the block and watching this fake facade that's on television instead of actually doing stuff for themselves and actually building relationships. Because at the end of the day, when you and I are gone, what's left over? Yes, we can make all this money, we can have all this assets and all the rest of it, but what value did you leave on the earth? What impact did you leave on the earth? Most people, look, I know a lot of people that have been hugely successful from a financial point of view, and then when they die, something happens, they're gone and there's no legacy left. See, life is not about just a dollar bill, it should be more than that. That's why I started doing this stuff online, and I know for a lot of you probably think it's weird, but for me, I like it. I like doing this. I like knowing that there's people out there going, what is that guy doing? I love the fact that there's people out there having a dig. I love that. Because do you know why? Because it frees you from the opinions of others. And so many people that are out there in the world today are so restricted because of what other people think of them. It's liberating to know that you're confident within yourself, that you can look in the mirror and you're happy with that person looking back at you. See, most people aren't. I sit in front of so many people, on average 30, 40 people a month. And so many people are so unsure of themselves. So many people, have no self-esteem. You know, you have these beautiful women and good-looking guys and all the rest of the stuff, in the gym. They've got, they're fit as hell and they've got the fake boobs and all this stuff going on. But underneath all of that, they're just scared. Half of them can't talk to you properly. And if you do talk to them, they think that you're hitting on them. That's how insecure people have become today. See, it doesn't matter about what you look like. It doesn't matter about how much money you got. It's what difference are you making? What impact are you making? And it doesn't have to mean you're going on social media doing videos like this. It doesn't mean that. What value are you adding to your community, your church, your family, whatever the case may be? Because all we do in society today is we pull down other people. I just don't understand why we need to keep pulling down other people. Why don't we praise people up? Why don't we lift people up? Instead of having a go at the guys that are out there and being successful financially in life, why aren't we praising those people? Because tall poppy syndrome is rampant in this society. What do we do when someone's doing good? We pull them down. Oh, that guy's ripping people off. He's doing property deals. That guy's doing insurance. All real estate agents are crooks. Not all real estate agents are bad people. Look, there might be some bad people in that industry, but there's a lot of good people in that industry. There's a lot of insurance brokers that might be a bit slimy, but there's a lot of good ones out there. There's so many different people out there in the world that get branded because of the industry they're working in. There's so many people that do videos like this on social media that are full of it. All they're trying to do is sell a service or a product. They don't actually give a stuff about the people. The reason why I started doing this was actually to add value to people. Because I find it sad that we live in a society where everyone just pulls each other down. Do you know the problem is there's a lot of people that will watch a video like this of me, for example. I'll use myself as an example because I'm in the firing line here a little bit. There'll be people out there that will bag me for what I'm doing here. But I guarantee you that those people wouldn't say it to my face. This is the gutless society we live in today. So I ask the question to you. What value are you adding to this world? What value are you adding to your children? Are you imprinting into putting into them the right principles so that they can go on and add value to other people? Or are you giving them the pessimistic attitude that you already have? Because that's how most people are living. And see, most people don't have the guts to front up and actually say, look, this person just said something out of line to me, and they just get bullied in the workplace. They never speak up. They never say anything. And it's because self-esteem is so low in people today. It doesn't have to be that way. Each and every one of you who is watching this video right now has huge, huge potential. You have so much potential, you just don't know that. And I didn't know that in my life. I know I haven't made it. I haven't arrived. I'm still going hard, doing the things that I'm doing. I have nowhere yet arrived. But one thing that I have learned is to love myself and realize that it's actually up to me whether or not I actually succeed in life. It's not up to the government. It's not up to the friends that you associate with. It's not up to anyone else other than myself. So if I wanted to go out there and get any level of success, I had to step out and I had to do something different. You know, if I know from the messages I get from people that some of my videos add value. Look, some of the stuff I say is not going to, you know, align with what you're thinking right now. But hopefully something in what I say is actually, you know, help someone out there realize that they're the person that's holding them back. Nothing else, not their job, nothing else is holding them back other than the person that's looking in the mirror. So what value are you going to add to your life first and foremost, because you've got to fill your cup first before you can fill the cups of others? What value are you going to add to your life, and then what value can you add to this world? Because one day you and I are going to be gone. What legacy are you going to leave behind? What legacy are you going to leave behind? Because one thing that I lived with fear was understanding that one day when I'm gone, that I whenever that may be, 50 years from now, whatever, whenever my time's up, that I've left a legacy, that I've made a difference in some way or form. That I didn't worry about the opinions of others, that I went out and did it. So what value are you going to add to others? Go out there, make it happen, live your life to your full potential, and we'll see you at the top. Thanks for listening. Have an awesome, what day is it today? Thursday afternoon. Drive safe, and we'll see you again. Cheers.